Prior to measuring the skin folds, each site is carefully marked on the right side of the body using either bony landmarks on the trunk or midpoints between well-defined bones on the limbs. For each site, the skin fold is lifted up at a location 2 centimeters, or approximately 3/4 of an inch, above the point at which the caliper tips will be placed. The thumb and index fingers separate the subcutaneous fat from the underlying muscle. Just enough skin and adipose tissue is taken up to form a distinct fold. The jaws of the calipers are placed perpendicular to the length of the fold, while the technician continues to hold the skin fold. The actual measurement is read from the caliper dial 3 seconds after the caliper tips are applied to the skin, and the tension is released from the caliper handle. The skin fold thickness is measured in millimeters to the nearest tenth of a millimeter. On some individuals, it's not possible to separate the fat from the muscle tissue. When a distinct fold of skin and subcutaneous fat cannot be made with confidence, an appropriate note should be entered on the data recording form, and a measurement value should not be recorded. The thigh skin fold is measured on the right thigh at the point previously marked for the thigh circumference. Following the same procedure used in positioning the subject for thigh circumference, the subject stands with most of the weight on the left leg, with the right leg forward, knees slightly flexed, and the soles of both feet flat on the floor. The skin fold is taken up in the midline of the thigh, with the measuring technician's fingers centered just above the mark. The tips of the caliper jaws are placed perpendicular to the length of the fold, 2 centimeters from the fingertips, and centered over the marked point. The triceps skin fold is measured on the right upper arm, at the point previously marked for the mid-upper arm circumference. The subject stands upright, with feet together, shoulders relaxed, and the arms hanging loosely at the sides. The technician stands behind the subject and gently lifts the tricep skin fold, with fingertips centered just above the mark. The tricep skin fold is held parallel to the long axis of the upper arm. The tips of the caliper jaws are placed perpendicular to the length of the fold, 2 centimeters from the fingertips, and centered over the marked point. The subscapular skin fold is measured with the subject standing upright, shoulders relaxed, and arms hanging loosely at the sides. The technician stands behind and gently palpates the inferior angle of the right scapula, which is to say the lowermost tip of the triangular bone. A mark is made on the inferior angle of the scapula. The technician gently lifts a fold of skin and subcutaneous adipose tissue with the index finger directly above and medial to the mark at the inferior angle of the scapula, and with the thumb reaching toward the spine. The skin fold forms a line extending diagonally toward the right elbow. The jaws of the caliper are placed perpendicular to the length of the fold, 2 centimeters from the fingertips, with the tip of the top caliper jaw directly on the mark at the inferior angle of the scapula. The supra-iliac skin fold is measured at a point anterior to the mark previously made to measure waist circumference. The subject stands in an upright position with weight evenly distributed and feet together. The examination gown is held so that the waist area on the right side is exposed. The technician's thumb is placed on the intersecting marks, and the index finger is placed above and anterior to the mark. The skin fold slopes downward at approximately a 45-degree angle toward the pubic symphysis. The tips of the caliper jaws are placed approximately 2 centimeters below the fingertips.